Hey guys, I'm Jai with Gear Contact, and today we're introducing our latest product, the iFootage Shark Slider. Now the first thing you'll see is its compact design, two handles and a shoulder strap for convenience. It's got a waterproof layer so your equipment doesn't get wet, and it's got an external pocket for additional counterbalances or whatever else you need. Now, let's have a look inside. Okay, now you can see that this is a foam interior to protect your equipment as opposed to the hard exterior. There's two pockets other than the actual product itself. Here are the two additional carbon fiber poles, and we've got an extension belt over here. Now let's have a look at it. Let's get it out. There we go. Okay, so this is the product itself. Now as you'll see, we've got these two rails here. They're made from carbon fiber with a very smooth finish. There's a repeated design everywhere. All of this, that's the CNC machine made grooves, which help to reduce the weight while keeping the structural integrity the same. If we flip it over, we could check out the back here. There's a cheese board design. If we look at the slider itself down here, it's got two spirit levels to make sure everything's balanced. And that's it. Let's fix it to the tripod, see what happens. So here's the slider mounted on a tripod. As you can see, it's a nice, smooth track. That's thanks to the carbon fiber finish and the belt inside. But as with all sliders, if you let it go, it comes to a bit of an abrupt stop. So that's where the counterweight comes in. It's easily attachable, just like this. And what this does is it adds a bit of momentum and a bit of inertia to the shot. So if you slide it, it's a nice, easy out, a nice, smooth track. The great thing about this is you can add an additional counterweight. And what that will do will allow larger cameras to use the same feature as well as macro lenses, so you can get the same effect over a short distance. A nice, smooth track. Now, as you can see, we've got this fixed on a tripod, but it does come with these legs already attached, so you can just mount it anywhere. Another convenience feature. Thank you. Okay, now let's look at some of the features on the bottom of the slider. First of all, we've got this hole here. That's for attaching the strap from the bag so you can carry it around more conveniently. We've got three mounting options. We've got the 3/8 hole, we've got the quarter hole, and we've got the light stand hole, which we'll show you in a minute. Additionally, we've got these legs built into the bottom of the slider with adjustable heights. And if you need a really low angle shot, we've got these four little feet on the bottom. Let's have a look at the underside of the slider module itself. Now we've got my favorite feature, this little Allen key holder, so you never lose another one of those guys. We've got these two adjustable locks so you can adjust the tension of the belt, and we've got the belt itself, which is a S3M quality belt, which is the highest you can get. Finally, we've got this. It's a lock for the slider, so it doesn't move when you don't want it to. Okay, let's mount it onto a lighting stand. Now, attaching the slider to a lighting stand is simple. There you go, you slip it in the holes, and you screw it on. Done. You've got the same experience with two lighting stands. Now, the default length of the rail itself is 0.7 meters. Now, the two main complaints in similar products like this are that when you add the extension rail, you lose the weight capability. At 1.2 meters, you can still support 5 kilograms with this guy. Also, the second complaint is that the joint is typically not smooth, but there you go, there's no bump at all when you slide it over. Thanks for watching, guys. For more details and everything gear contact, visit the website.